We're here in Skipton on yet another glorious sunny day where we've just started the process of converting the area behind us into a parking area that's suitable to charge electric vehicles. We're going to be installing 2x22 kilowatt AC chargers and installing them and connecting them to the electrical installation in the building behind us. We've just started the groundworks. Now, when it comes to groundworks, there's always the risk that you could strike an existing underground service. And probably the one we're most worried about is the electrical service. So in this video, we're going to look at the precautions you can take to avoid a nasty accident. Now, we certainly know this building has a substantial three-phase electrical supply because we can see the intake behind us, we can see the cable vanishing down through the wall and underground, but what we don't know is, does it turn left or does it go right? And is it going to be directly in the area where we're going to be installing our EV charger? How can we find that out? Well, the secret is obviously on this drawing here that I obtained from the distribution network operator, which in this area is Northern Powergrid. Getting hold of a safe dig plan is real easy. Just Google Northern Powergrid safe dig. Obviously other DNOs have different methods of doing this. May not be as easy as this. Already got an account with safe dig to get the records. So simply log in, start a new application. We'll call this something sensible like eFIXX EV charger installation. But before doing that, just accept some terms and conditions. I'm sure no responsibility held if there's an error in the plans. That is still down to you, and we'll come on to that later. So again, yes, just put in our project name. When will this work take place? Well, we're already doing it, so that's we'll put that down as today, and we hope to have it finished by the end of the week if all goes to plan. And we're working on behalf of the builder here. So we're and the on-site area, we're going to be doing mechanical excavation, and it is on private land. So you must remember, the plans that come through on this will all identify the cables that belong to the DNO. They wouldn't identify any private cables or street lighting cables necessarily. So again, there's some more precautions. So we're going to put in the postcode of the project and then navigate to that on this map. So there we are, there's the approximate area. So let's just zoom in on the area we're going to be working. It's amazing how granular you can go in this. So yeah, just about, yes, that does look like the area we're working in. So then we're just going to accept that that's the right area. And then we're just going to draw the area that where the excavation is going to take place. Gone a little bit wider here, just to see what else is in the area. So we're just going to draw a little rectangle around the area. So really easy. Just extend there. And back round. That's it, that's our area defined. So then just type the sort of size of plan. So that looks A4 will probably be ideal for our purpose, and the shape of that portrait. And then we get two scales, so we'll go as close as possible, 1 to 250 on the scale. Next. And then that's our, just double check, that's the project. Yep, that looks right. Just confirm those details. Finish, and that is our application done. So that was a really simple process. A few minutes later, I've got a notification in my email that my plans are ready to download. So log back in and then we can see our safe dig plan for the area we've just shown. And lo and behold, it's showing the exact route of the cables. So here's the front of the property, the road outside. And we can see we've got two cables feeding into each unit. And obviously they're not connected. So it looks like there's a clear channel through the middle. We're going to be digging here at the back. It looks like on the other side of the wall down there is an 11 kV cable running down the road. We're certainly not going to be going anywhere near that. A few things to remember about these plans. They are obviously approximate, so don't take this as absolute gospel. We are still going to have to validate that that cable is in that area. They also don't tell you the depth of the cable as well, which is again another important thing to note. So we're going to have to make quite a large hole at the back for our EV charge point to go in there. We're going to put an EV block in there, so that's where we're going to be going deep. And what we've just discovered, believe it or not, is this plan doesn't show you water pipes, but it's all right because we've found them. So we've got our plan and we know the approximate area the cables are located. It is now time to validate that with this CAT scanner, or that cable avoidance tool. So this tool here will scan the ground and is looking for the magnetic field or metal associated with pipes and cables. So what we do first is we scan the area, all around the area, because obviously we may be able to identify some cables that aren't owned by the DNO that could be under there, possibly some legacy installs, but then obviously focus in on the area where we do believe the cable is. And obviously we have got some other clues as to that cable being there because we know where our distribution and service head is. And then it's a case of just marking them out to avoid that area when it comes to using the digger, and that's an area we'll be doing some hand excavation. You'll notice that we've sprayed up two cables out there. One's the power service that is marked on this plan, but the cable avoidance tools also identified this telecom service that is also in the area where we're going to be excavating. So we've planned our dig carefully. We've scanned to prove the location of those cables before we dig. Now it's down to doing a bit of hand digging in the area where we believe the cables are located. And that's what we've done here as we're putting in our cable duct. So we're going to run our ducting in through the building here. So we've started there. As we dug down there, actually, we found another cable. It wasn't the three-phase one we're expecting to feed our building. Now, we're looking for other clues, aren't we? We found the marker that's put above the cable duct to indicate there's a cable supply there. We obviously had to go deeper than that. So again, careful hand digging, we found what we believe was a single phase supply into the building that was used before the three phase was installed here. And the builder wisely asked us to prove that that cable was dead. And that's what we did before we obviously removed that. We've also found the marker for our three phase supply, and interestingly it is further out from the building that is shown on this plan. So that's why a reason always to take a pinch of salt with these plans. It's the approximate area, not the exact area. We can see the cable marker above that cable. We're not going to be going any deeper for our excavation because we've got our EV blocks located in and we've got a satisfactory depth that we're happy with for the cable route that we're going to use. So now we can crack on and install our cable ducting. So we're now at the stage where we're about to finish our groundworks on this project and put the cable ducting in. So we planned carefully where the cable routes were likely to encounter were. We scanned to prove that they were in this area, then we carefully hand dug to expose them so we knew how to avoid them when we're running our cable duct. So we're going to crack on with the rest of this installation. It's part of a bigger series where we're going to turn this area into an EV charging area within our car park. Check out that video series. I'll leave a link in the description below. So we've nearly finished our groundwork installation here. We're just waiting for the tarmac to be applied. Our EV blocks are in the ground and our ductwork has now been hidden by the hardcore that's in here. But obviously before we put that hardcore down, we've obviously thought about that next person who may be coming along in the future and maybe doing some future excavations, and we've laid our warning tape in there, so if they start removing the surface, they'll get an early warning that there is a cable duct in there. And as ever, we look forward to getting your comments as well. Have you got any safe excavation tips that we haven't covered in this video, or any other advice you'd like to share with the community? Put your comments below.